Hello, it is, and welcome back to Phoenix Wright Tribulations. We are going to continue and cross-examine Gertrude's testimony from last episode, so... Yeah, so let's just begin. This armored person, you have no idea who it might be, right?
Sorry, but I'm afraid I do.
What?
The one who called Sergeant Hunter was the defendant, Flawless.
What? The defendant? The defendant called her?
Sergeant Hunter was a very true woman. Person, sir. She left a note about her phone call with Mr. Flawless.
A note?
Yeah, a top secret memo that she left on her desk.
Written. According to the note, this is the one who called the bridge was indeed the defendant, Terry Fallis.
Whose bright idea was it to keep the note from me?
Ha! So suddenly you're just even more serious. Sure of his spirit now. Listen up. Never ask the question if you don't already know the answer.
Is that the detective's fault? He's the one who said that on a person.
Hey now, don't make the face at me. I just said it was the way because the prosecutor told me to.
Was that a trap? With that cute face? I didn't expect it to be so sneaky.
Press everything.
A bishop in the mountains, but why meet there?
Because it is a very important place to defend it, that's why.
What do you mean by that?
If you remember correctly, 5 years ago the defendant kidnapped a young girl. He was chased onto the bridge and it was there that he killed his hostage. And the place where all of this occurred is of course the bridge.
The very place where Sergeant Hartle arrested the attack of Mr. Follis.
Ha! Returned to the scene of the crime, nostalgic.
And that's where she was brutally murdered, sir. Was the body of the victim discovered right away?
Yeah, we were really on the ball. We found the criminal within 1 hour of the murder. It was great! We even got to say, don't move, we got you surrounded!
Wait a second, isn't there something weird about that?
The location was a special bridge. Up in the mountains. So how did they find out about the cruiser quickly?
So Shahat must have messaged the phone call to someone else, right?
Ha! If that's what happened, then she would not be killed. She never mentioned a phone call from Mr. Flawless, but she left a note on the desk about it. If only I noticed it earlier, maybe she'd be still alive.
I wonder why she didn't mention a phone call to anyone.
Mr. Flawless had a car in.
Well, that bridge is way up there in the mountains, ma'am. The defendant and the victim both went up there by car. I mean, who else, right?
What? You mean the defendant drove his own car?
No, of course not. It was stolen. He stole it from a young couple that had been waiting at the red light.
Car thieves? I'm not sure how we feel about car thieves.
Is this guy sure about how he feels about anything?
This is a photo of the stolen car truck. Actually, that's the body of the Hawthorne in there.
Wow, that doesn't look too comfortable.
The victim, she was stabbed in the back, correct?
Yeah. Ha. For some reason, men always seems to get stabbed in the back.
We're talking about the woman here.
You can tell from this photo that the knife was stuck in her back nice and firm.
The condition of the body when it was discovered is very poor information. Detective must identify stranger not really in the trunk of the car.
It's a part of the trunk, but I don't see anything strange, do you?
Check.
Check all evidence.
Check. February 14th, blah blah blah, flawless, blah blah, that bridge, blah blah, where I scoffed for identification, blah blah, talk to Dahlia.
Dahlia? Like in Dahlia Hawthorne?
Dahlia, oh my god, not her, not her, please!
White scarf? But she doesn't have a white scarf.
Objection!
Objection! Witness!
What is it? Do you have something to say, Miss Bay?
Sorry, I forgot what I was going to say. This is the first time I ever had to ask to address someone like that.
You should have packed it before coming to the court. Honestly, Miss Faye, I'm not sure I like this.
Say this. Say. Say, little didn't want a piece of my coffee candy.
Candy?
Well, you are still too young to be drinking real coffee.
Come on, Mia, shake it off. You're a lawyer! Detective! Yes, ma'am!
This photo... You said there was nothing... peculiar about it, is that correct?
Yeah, that's what I said.
Well then, I suggest you take another look at the note written by Dick then.
The note?
It's very clear, it very clear says. Where Wright's covered with identification. The colonists have forgotten what the victim looked like, thus this special request.
I have one very simple question for you, Detective. Where is the white scarf?
I guess you didn't find it in this photo.
To be honest, I didn't find it in the trunk, ma'am.
Are you stopped there? You should have looked for it!
The caller told her to wear it to identify herself, so I did expect that she did just that. Well, Mr. Schmidt, what do you have to say about this?
I see the defense is a little lacking. The scarf you are searching so desperately for. Is it this one, perhaps? Perchance? Whatever.
Where did you find us, sir?
Bridge. I was there first, I decided to conduct my own investigation.
Why? What did you tell me?
I made a decision to keep all pieces of evidence in my personal session. It's the safest place I know. That hot shot sure is a flare for the romantic. It's not exactly white as the caller requested, but as you can see, it's close enough for what it was intended for.
It looks like I spent lots of time in the mud.
Not surprising, it was dancing on the mountain that day.
Prosecutor Edgeworth! He was intentionally hiding his scarf the whole time!
The court will accept the scarf as the evidence.
Now, if the attorney of the defense is finished embarrassing himself, I'd like to move on with the testimony. That is alright with you, isn't it, Miss Faye?
Boy, I would like to wrap that scarf around this charming little neck.
Very good. Now, if you're done with this mud-covered scarf business, the prosecution moves to establish conclusively and be with hard evidence that Miss Hawthorne and Mr. Fawless did indeed meet on the Dusky Bridge on the bridge that day. Further, we will show exactly how that occurred.
That's not quite promising. I can't wait to hear about it.
Everything is moving at the swim.
Don't forget, kitten. There's a reason why everyone considers this kid as a genius.
A genius, huh? With a cute face.
and fence on the desk branch.
Actually, there's an eyewitness who was there when the incident took place. This photo was accidentally taken by the witness. It shows her very discussor. It was this late at night, unfortunately, it's a little hard to see what's going on. Anyway, the aggressor shot the victim down from behind and stabbed her in the back. That must have been when the scarf fell off.
Looking at this photo. You really get the sense that these bridges were high up.
It is about a 40 feet drop from the bridge to the Eagle River down below.
Mr. Ashwood, Mr. Rue took this photo anyway.
Let's just say it was a well-intentioned third party.
Ah, potential witness, so why is this person in the courtroom?
Well, they say they absolutely don't want to testify. The person's question is very delicate, Your Honor. Delicate. Besides, as long as we have this photo, we see no reason to compel her to testify.
I'm not sure how I feel about that.
So as you can see, Terry Follis has had both the motive and the opportunity to think it's quite clear at this point what happened at the bridge.
It's quite clear to me now.
Huh? Again?
Yes, it's quite obvious. It's clearly guilty.
Not again, that's not fair. I haven't done my cross-examination yet. What do you mean,
Actually, there's an eyewitness on the stage, blah blah blah. Accidentally.
Hold it! The victim is very scared of the photo, right? So about the witness who took this photo? What was this person doing all the way in the mountains?
She was taking photos of white flowers, apparently. There are many unusual types of flora on that mountain, Miss Faye. People in the area say it's because of the spirits that live there.
Spirits?
Now that I mentioned it, this photo. This clarifying thing. Is it a ghost? I don't believe it!
No, Your Honor, no, I don't think it's a ghost.
I don't know what you take of this witness's statement.
I don't take anything of it. How about you?
I guess I don't take anything of it here.
Then we don't have a problem. We do have a penalty.
Is it? If there was a continuous landslide,
was that possible?
Is that part of the witness testimony as well?
Of course it is.
He pushed the victim hard in the back as she fell down right on her stomach.
I remember that happening almost myself. It was really brutal.
Are you talking about seeing someone who got pushed over where you don't get pushed? Or does it mean that you have pushed someone down like that once? With his wine bungling tales and the way he said brutal, I wonder if it's Canadian.
I was right!
Save your nasty look for the right person.
Huh?
Take a look. Poor baby, the court record seems to have wet itself.
Hey, what's your brand new spilled coffee?
The court record, huh? Surprise, I had no idea who there was a photo.
So what did you do?
You really still believe in him? Mr. Crybaby, I mean.
Of course you do!
So little kid believes in fairy tales, so. In that case, the answer is obvious. If what you believe is the truth, then I missed it somewhere hidden in that testimony is a contradiction. One huge contradiction waiting to be discovered, that's your chance.
eyewitness.
She's a college student.
A female college student?
That's right. And she's a female and a college student, ma'am. She doesn't do well in front of all the people, so I came here to testify for her.
Maybe so, but that's not only for the defense. I have the right to cross-examine her.
For the time being, we are not relying on the witness testimony. The witness's statement, that is all.
But what is that supposed to mean?
The prosecution has ordered more decisive evidence. Our case doesn't rest on the vague testimony of a female college student.
A female college student, eh?
It means she's a female and a college student, sir. If you absolutely must hear her testimony, you will have to give us some good reason why.
Please tell us about the more decisive evidence question.
This photo was actually taken by the witness to show her wearing a scarf, sir.
This sling? Drizzling, huh?
That's right. There was a light rain coming down. The whole place was dreary. But not as dreary as the mood that is in this courtroom right now. Looks like a cold front just moved in. In any case, the point is that the area was quite damp. It was even so fog. I even slipped and fell while I was on the bridge. It was just something.
But how is that possible?
Wait a minute.
Back testimony. Step with the knife in the back door from Bruno's between 4 and 5. Check the note.
You're not just a little bit of a lag.
Point of fingers, I'm never pointing.
I was right!
So at the time of the crime, there was a light drizzle coming down, correct?
Yeah, the fog too, just to generate some atmosphere.
Well, I have evidence that doesn't go with the soggy atmosphere.
But this is a photo of the victim's body that was holding a car trunk.
Consider the condition of at the scene of the crime, something isn't right.
And sure knows what I'm talking about.
Well, by all means, please enlighten us with us as to what's not right. What is it about this photo that the drug that doesn't fit for the condition of this case?
Naturally, the answer is here. Right here.
The victim's coat? As far as I can see, there is nothing strange about it.
That exactly was strange. Remember the testimony? What were the condition of the bridge that day?
It was drizzling and foggy. The bridge was all wet. If the doctor really had fallen down on her stomach on top of the bridge, then the front of her car would have been covered in mud. That's just right! The other day I fell on the muddy street and my gorgeous playoff mirror was befouled.
I do admit that the crime scene was quite wet that day. However, that doesn't mean that the top of the bridge resembles muddy. If your owner had fallen in a shower instead of a muddy street, his glorious hockey beer prior of the legal league would be wet, but not muddy.
Fortunately, I have yet to test that. Still, your point is well taken.
Can you prove that the surface of the bridge was muddy that day?
The surface of the bridge?
Huh? A real man wouldn't stand for a tot like this.
Neither would a real woman. I will show you. Of course I can. Here's the evidence that proves the surface of the bridge was muddy.
Oh my god, don't be so jumpy right now.
The evidence is the scarf!
Oh!
It should be obvious. If the scarf fell into the bridge and got this water spreading, it means that the bridge was obviously covered in mud.
No, I can't be offended by this novice bimbo.
Hey, same to you, buddy!
Novice bimbo. Oh, I can be so much this stuff is pinball.
Miss Mason's assertion makes perfect sense to me.
I do admit that this appears to be a contradiction between the condition of the winter's coat and scarf. However, the real question is, why is there a contradiction? Huh? For every contradiction, there exists an explanation. Let's look at what the explanation in this case may be, shall we?
Alright. It's not like he's really giving me a choice here.
Ha! You're doing pretty good, for a little kitten.
Mr. Armando!
No matter what he says, a contradiction always goes down to a lie. It's either the victim's discovered in the trunk, the victim's push photo showing the defendant and the victim, or the witness testimony that stated she saw the moment of the murder. Just relax and think it over. It's pretty simple, isn't it? The false evidence is one of those three.
Huh? What are you saying now? You're not sure like that.
I like that. That was me, Honor. It was the coffee aficionado over here that said it.
This court is not in the habit of accepting false evidence, you know.
Well, not him, your honor. He's the one trying to slip out false evidence into court. But we won't let him. We will expose his evidence and slip this scam into release.
Yes! The false evidence in this case is the... It was a no-brainer! Obviously, it's the witness... What is this suspicious? During his early testimony, the detective pointed out the crucial fact. The criminal showed the victim's down from behind and stabbed her in the back. Now is that just what exactly what the witness claims to have seen?
Yeah, that's what the witness told us.
That testimony is filled with holes. After all, the victim's coat isn't dirty at all.
That's true.
Ha! It's not just true, it's the truth. If that's what you're going to see the witness in this case, I'm certain that boy wonder over there wouldn't have called them in the first place.
Your Honor, the defense requests to cross-examine the eyewitness. The testimony presented so far is not only vague, but contradictory as well.
Well, Mr. Edward, it appears that we need to hear from your mystery witness after all.
You should brace yourself for the brutal truth. Your Honor, the prosecution has no intention of hiding the witness from the court. We are prepared to present our witness at any time.
Very well, please bring forth your witness at this time.
What Mr. Ashworth said kind of worries me. What does he mean by that brutal truth?
Now let's proceed with the testimony. Mr. Ashworth, please go right ahead.
Thank you, Your Honor. The prosecution summons. The woman saw the events that day with her own eyes.
This is it, Mia. The barber begins here.
Witness. Witness, what is your name and occupation?
Oh no, it's her again! The devil woman! Everyone is so silent that they can hear the horse going pitter-patter.
Oh, when I look at you, how can I put it? You look as scumptious as a double-double and a dozen darn-littles. I feel like I want to hurry it up and head down a verdict just to have a bite.
Hey, it was fast!
As I said before, this point is very sensitive and delicate. I would ask the court to please exercise care when addressing her.
Yes, indeed. Thank you, Mr. Ashworth. You are a true gentleman. This way, you can learn a lot from this man.
If he's just a gentleman, he sure doesn't act like one to me. Sir?
Yes, my dear?
This is my first time, so I'm sure he will make a lot of mistakes. Anyway, I just want to say I'm sorry for all the trouble I might cause.
No, no, it's no trouble at all.
Now then, may we please have your name and occupation?
My name is, Melissa Foster.
You liar.
I'm a college student. I'm fresh with the literature department.
You were on the scene when the unfortunate event occurred, correct? And you were the one who took the photo? This photo? Is that accurate?
Oh, okay, what does it mean?
This is so false.
Now see here, what are you doing showing that in your face like that?
Huh? But it's just a photograph. It's not like it's off a dangerous.
Next time, I'm forced to paralyze you.
Uh-oh, I don't like the turn this is taken. Is he staring at me?
And you would be...
Huh? I'm the defense lawyer. My name is CFA.
I see. So you are...
No, no, Your Honor. Could you please give us your testimony?
Yes, Your Honor. I will do my best. I butterflies.
Okay, guys, after this episode, we get to meet Dahlia again, and her butterflies, and her devil self. So, yeah, we'll be there. Cross-examine the witness photograph this morning next time. So, thank you for watching. Leave a like, comment, subscribe if you liked it. And thank you for support as always. And I hope to see you in the next video.